Hey guys, how are you? It's Nikki from Nikki Barta Fitness. So today I would like to share with you a couple of abdominal exercises, okay? But it's really going to focus on your core. You don't need anything else except yourself. Now, before we start, I would like to go through with you on your core muscles, because so many times I am asking, hey, what is your core muscles? What do you think? Which is true. But your core muscles is not just your abdominals, okay? Imagine if you cut your head, your arms, and your legs down. That's your core muscles, forward and backwards as well, okay? So you basically your abdominals, your whole back, your glutes, so the posterior chain muscles, okay? So regarding that, today I'm going to focus on the front. So let's lie down. First, to warm up your abdominals, I'm going to do some crunches. However, what's normally happening when we do crunches, and obviously bend is the best exercise that you can ever imagine, is just simply using your neck and your shoulders, okay? So I don't want you to do this, so please watch me for the first two reps and then you can join me. So number one, when you're lying down, your feet nice and close, but like comfortably. Feet hit with the part, or it could be a little bit wider. Now you're going to interlock your fingers bring it behind the head. Okay, elbows not too close, not too wide neither. So I want you to be able to see your elbows from the corner of your eyes. From here, straight ahead, chin tucked in. So imagine you have a little marble ball underneath your chin and you're holding on between the chin and the chest. You're going to breathe in. And as I breathe out, I crunch up with my tummy, inhaling at the top, and then exhaling to roll down. Now watch me again. Inhale, as I exhale, I'm shortening my tummy muscles, hold it up while I'm breathing in, and I'm breathing out, I'm lengthening my tummy muscles. Now you can join me, so breathe in, breathe out. Squeeze your tummy muscles to the belly button. Inhale, as you exhale, rolling down. Now, as you see, my elbows are not moving at all. So if my elbows coming in and I'm going wide as I'm going down, then I know I'm working with my neck and the shoulders. Keep going, you're gonna go for a good 15 reps. But you keep going, I'm just gonna explain it. So again, think about your base muscles. So the muscles are shortening as you're rolling up and then lengthening as you're going down. What do you have to be aware of that? Chin tucked into the chest. So if I'm looking right up to the ceiling and this is how I'm going up, I'm putting so much pressure on that neck, okay? That's why it's important to keep the chin tucked in, okay? So from here, rolling up. Inhale at the top, I'm looking right between my legs, and then exhale, I'm rolling down. Now make sure that your nudes starts from the abs. So before my neck, before my shoulders nudes, breathe in, breathe out, use your tummy to roll up, breathe in, breathing out, rolling down. Now, if you're shaking on the top, that's good. That means your core muscle is working. If you feel it right over here, good. You shouldn't feel it in your neck, you shouldn't feel it in your shoulders because we're supporting the head. Let's do two more. If you don't already do 15, you still do another two more with me. And at this stage, you should really feel the tummy muscles, it started to generate a bit of heat on. Now breathe in, breathe out, hold up. Now, as you're holding it up for me, what I really want you to focus on is check your elbows. Is it too close? Is it too wide? No, make sure you're able to see them from the corner of your eyes. We're going to add the breathing. If you need a quick rest, please do so, because I'm 100% sure that this one should feel as much as it feels for me, burning sensation. So that means that the muscles are working as the heat started to generate over here. So if you need a quick rest, please do so. Otherwise, if you are able to hold it, think about it. Breathe into your tummy. As you breathe out, squeeze your tummy in. So we're staying up, we hold. Breathe optimal. Breathe in. Breathe out. Squeeze. Once you're shaking, it's good. Keep looking right between the legs. Breathe in. Breathe out. Squeeze. And release. Good. Bring both knees to your chest. Nice and lower side to side. Take it easy. So we're going to move this on. You can do it 5 times, 10 times. Okay? So breathing into your tummy, breathing out. And you're squeezing it as hard as you can. If you do feel pressure in your neck, please put the head down, rest for a couple of seconds, okay? But if you do it right and correctly, tummy muscles, okay? Next one, coming up into your leg taps, you've got two options, guys. So option number one, you're setting it up, breathing, breathe out, feet front up. From here, breathing, breathe out. One leg lift up into the tabletop position, breathing, breathe out, opposite leg. From here, option number one, finger taps. Inhale, exhale, tap. Lift as you inhale, exhale, tap. Inhale, lift. Now, if you feel this is a bit too much for you today, just usually take the head down, bring the hands next to your body, and keep going with these taps. Always make sure that your knees are coming just above your hips. So try not to bring it in too much and always wait for the opposite leg, okay? So I'm tapping, I'm lifting, I'm tapping, I'm lifting. Keep going, you can give me a good 20 reps on each side. So 10-10, okay? But keep alternating. So whatever option you are, what you have to be aware is that lower back. So mainly when you're putting your head down, what's normally happening is just to let the hips tilting forward, okay? I want you to make sure that you keep rotating your hips in. So even if you're up here, you should feel that your hips is not moving. And again, be lengthening, be shortening. So I really want you to focus on that muscle, mind-muscle connection, okay? So be aware of this, like it's not just the legs tap down and back up, okay? I want you to make sure that nice and controlled. Exhale down, inhale, exhale down, inhale. Let's do six. Okay, four. Let's do another four. I'm gonna come up from here. Inhale, exhale, tap, inhale, back, exhale, tap, inhale, back. Middle down. Two more. Let's finish it together. And then the last one. And that's it. Good. And then knees to your chest. You can bring your hands out and just nice and easy roll side to side. Okay? Easy down. Now, next one, we're gonna go for a full C crunch. Okay? How does it look like? So feet back, arms back. From here, again, set up your arms. Make sure that your hips is tilted forward. Breathe in as you breathe out. Upper body legs in one time. Inhale, coming down. Exhale, up. Inhale, coming down. Don't forget, chin tucked into the chest, okay? And don't forget, hips not moving, body is not moving. Just really that abdominals. I already feel that I'm actually building that burning sensation back up. So again, if you do it right, you should feel that tummy is working because we're shortening now and then we're lengthening, okay? If you need your option, you can keep your head down, keep going with the double tap options, okay? But what you have to be aware is the hip. So the hip is not rotating forward, not rotating backwards, it just locked in. Let's go for another five more. I'm planning to do around 15, 20. I actually lost counting. But let's finish it together. Four. Exhale. Three. Last two for me. And one more. Up and hold. Up and hold. Now, I know you really hate me, but I want you to up and hold. Even if it's just 5 seconds. Even if you're keeping your legs up, but you need to bring the head down. Just hold it for me. Stay with me, okay? Keep hold. Now, from here, can you bring your hands to the top of your knees? And what I want you to do, push your knees in, but pushing your hands with your hands away. So in 3, 2, and push. You really feel the burning sensation. Even if your head is down, completely fine. Just push. Another 10, 9. Stay with me. Not dropping it down. Use it from your tummy. Not just the arms. 4, 1, 3, 2. Good job. And now just go nice and easy, side to side, take it easy. So guys, again, if you do this right, you should definitely feel that core engagement, okay? Try to maintain the rep chain between 10 and 15. You don't need to do more because your core is obviously gonna get like super tired and then you start to go into the wrong technique. So what I would do, 10, 15 of each exercise with a 30 seconds hold or even 20 seconds. So always listen to your body. And you can do 2-3 sets. Even if you want to do more, you can do even